Hello and welcome to my video. Today I'm going to teach you how to play Fields and Pier by Arians and Quires. As you've seen in the title of the video already, I've seen some covers and some interpretations of the song online already, but I don't think they're quite right, so I'm doing this video to show you how to play it the correct way. I've seen the live version of him playing the song, and I've listened carefully to his recordings, and I think I figured out the correct way how he plays it. The first thing we need to do is to change the pitch of the G string. The G string goes higher up two frets to an A. Sound like this. Instead of this, you get this. So everything remains standard is except from the G string. So it's E, A, D, A again, B, and then high E. The second step is to get a capo and put it on the second fret. Now we're good to go. So the song goes something like this.
Take me far away from here, from here. Started walking from the fields to the pier. I will stay upon your mind when I'm gone. And fine, I won't be gone for long.
So, what have I done here? It's quite simple, it's just three chords, so, and we got an B, an A, and an F sharp. And the way he plays it, it's no strumming at all, it's just finger picking. We put the middle finger on the 7th fret on the D string for the first chord, for the B. The index finger on the same fret, on the 7th fret, but on the A string for the A. For the B. And then the pinky and middle finger, or index finger, however you want it. For me, it's more comfortable than the middle finger. On the 9th fret, on the A string, for the F sharp. And the strumming pattern is quite simple as well. Don't worry, it's very easy, in fact. It's like this. Hope you can see it well. Got it? So, thumb, index, middle finger, and thumb again. And then the second string, the B string. And at the end, double thumb. That is for the chords, for the first two chords. And then for the third chord, we do something like this. So the high F sharp and then the low octave of the F sharp. And again on the B. Then for the part like, for that high part, we do the same three chords but inverted. We start with an F sharp, then the E, and the B. And now for the last part, when Avi does the low bass notes, he just stays on the B. The melody goes something like this. And he stays on. It's quite difficult to pick and sing it at the same time, but well, he's a genius. He can do it. I can't do it. But anyways, that's all. That's the whole song. So I hope you enjoyed my video. If you have any questions left for the song in particular, leave a comment below. I'm free to answer anything. Leave a like. Well, till next time.